Hare Krishna. What the mind makes us do would be comic if its consequences were not so tragic. Sometimes in a comedy show, we see some people doing something remarkably stupid. And they keep doing it not once, not twice, but many, many times. And when that happens, it becomes ludicrous. Some people are so dumb that the same thing they don't understand. And when we see them being so dumb, it is actually hilarious. However, we don't understand that many times the joke may well be on us. Actually, our mind also makes us do stupid things. And the mind impels us to do the same mistake, maybe oversleep again and again, overeat again and again. And these may well be the least harmful of the wrong things that the mind makes us do. And actually all of them, the mind's action, the actions impelled by the mind, many of them can have very serious consequences. Suppose somebody robs something, somebody lies, somebody does something illicit, and it can wreck people's lives. So the consequences can be catastrophic, and they are not just catastrophic, they're tragic, because all these are self-induced, in the sense that we didn't have to listen to the mind. So we need to recognize that dealing with the mind is no laughing matter. The Bhagavad-Gita urges us to become very serious, recognizing that the mind can be a deadly enemy and that it has to be dealt with great seriousness. The Bhagavad-Gita describes in 6:34 the characteristics of the mind, and it says its first characteristic is chanchala, restless like a child. Chanchalam himana krishna pramathi balavadrudham tasyaham nigraham manye vayorivasudushkaram. Chanchalam himana krishna, or my mind is restless, Arjuna is saying. But it is not just children who are restless, they are funny, they are entertaining. But this mind is pramathi, is mad, it is powerful, and it is badrudham, it's obstinate, and because of that it can become like a stormy wind which can just sweep us away and wreck us. So the more we understand how dangerous the mind is, the more we can become diligent in keeping a watch on it, and most importantly keeping ourselves connected with the one who will help us to keep a watch on it, that is on the divine. When we connect with Krishna and use whatever resources we have to strive to serve Him, then that diligence in striving to serve Him gives us the strength, the fortitude to regulate and ultimately transform our mind. Thank you. Hare Krishna.